This is the IBC Distribution Centre, Channel 10, International Stereo Sound for Television, left channel. This is the IBC Distribution Centre, Channel 10, International Stereo Sound for Television, left channel. This is the IBC Distribution Centre, Channel 10, International Stereo Sound for Television, left channel. This is the IBC Distribution Centre, Channel 10, International Stereo Sound for Television, left channel. This is the IBC Distribution Centre, Channel 10, International Stereo Sound for Television, left channel. This is the IBC Distribution Centre, Channel 10, International Stereo Sound for Television, left channel. This is the IBC Distribution Centre, Channel 10, International Stereo Sound for Television, left channel. This is the IBC Distribution Centre, Channel 10, International Stereo Sound for Television, left channel. This is the IBC Distribution Centre, Channel 10, International Stereo Sound for Television, left channel. This is the IBC Distribution Centre, Channel 10, International Stereo Sound for Television, left channel. This is the IBC Distribution Centre, Channel 10, International Stereo Sound for Television, left channel. This is the IBC Distribution Centre, Channel 10, International Stereo Sound for Television, left channel.
It was the men's individual H2 road race. And that's battled out over a course of 56 kilometres, which equates to 7 course laps. And here we have Heinz Frey from Switzerland, together with Walter Ablinger. And the Swiss guy really had the gold in the time trial, and he's now won 15 Paralympic gold medals altogether. He's got the world record in the men's marathon T54 class in 1999. He's 54 years old now, but really showing some great form. And these particular hand cycles, because they are lying down, they can steer with their feet. They go a little bit quicker than the others we've seen during the afternoon. And they will still use the method of slipstreaming, so that one guy at the front does all the work, or a lot of the work, coming downhill at the moment. And it's the Austrian, Walter Ablinger, that's taken it up, but he's being overtaken at the moment. Jean-Marc Besset is there, together with Vittorio Podesta. And the gearing on these, they've got seven different gears that they can use, and particularly here, that's when they need them most. It's up the hill. And they are really exposed to this heavy sunshine at the moment. It's a very, very tough task that they've got. 56 kilometers ahead of them. And here is Jean-Marc Besset. He is really working very hard. And coming through on the inside is the Italian, Vittorio Podesta. They are going to speeds of something like 20 kilometers an hour. But right now it's Walter Ablinger that is pushing hard, and he raises his arms in triumph. The 43-year-old from Austria has completed it in 1:37.55. A great victory for him. Jean-Marc Besset of Switzerland comes in second place, and the Italian, Vittorio Podesta, in third place here. And they all line up there just as you would a Formula One, I suppose. The crowd still applauding, waiting. In fact, here, isn't that wonderful? Mark Beggs and David Franek, Canada and France, link arms to cross the line in last place together. But the winners from Austria, Ablinger in second place, Besset, Podesta had the bronze.
North Greenwich Arena, the venue for the gold medal match in the women's wheelchair basketball. Australia playing Germany. A crowd of almost 13,000 there to see the climax to what's been a marvellous tournament. This was to be a famous night for Germany. They were to clinch their first Paralympic title, going one better than 4 years ago when they won the silver medal. Australia made a decent start, leading 10-4 at one stage, before the Germans closed the opening quarter with 10 points without reply. It was in the second quarter of the match that Germany made their move, taking control and never letting go. Marika Adermann was to finish up with 19 points. Arguably their best player at these games has been captain Marina Monum. Germany won all seven of their matches at London 2012, their success built on a solid defence. Australia's number 11, Kylie Gauchi, did her best to rouse her team. But there was no way back for an Australian side that's had to settle for the silver medal three times in the last four games. A sweet moment for Germany as the game ended. Final score, Australia 44, Germany 58. The bronze medal went to the Netherlands after they beat the USA, winners of the last two tournaments. silver to Australia, and gold in the women's wheelchair basketball going to Germany.
For the second Paralympics running, the USA and China lined up in pursuit of the gold medal. The Chinese were bidding for a hat-trick of titles, while the Americans were out for revenge, having been beaten in Beijing. It was the second time the teams had met in London, with China having won a pool match, and the US women had high hopes of avenging that defeat when they won the first set, courtesy of star player Catherine Holloway's superb spike. But China's indomitable spirit shone through again as they recovered from that early setback to level the match with a 25-15 success in set two. With both teams playing superbly, Holloway and Yu Hong Chen at the top of their games, the team served up a thriller, which went into the 30s before China, at the sixth attempt, sealed the longest set of the tournament, 32 points to 30. It was a crushing blow from which the Americans couldn't recover, and China maintained their vice-like grip on the event by landing the fourth set by a comfortable margin of 25-15 to claim their third gold medal. They remain the only team ever to have won the women's Paralympic sitting volleyball title, and six of this team have featured in all three of those triumphs. The USA claimed the deserved silver medal, and Ukraine's bronze was their first ever at this event. But the night, indeed the whole tournament, belongs to China.
The game between Great Britain and Belgium in wheelchair rugby was to help decide minor placings. The hosts in white were still smarting from failing to reach the semi-finals, but they were to gain some consolation in this match. It was a close-run thing, though. Belgium led at the end of the first quarter. Their team is built around their number eight, Lars Mertens, but he wasn't to have the same influence in this match. The man who did make the difference was Aaron Phipps. Belgium just couldn't cope with Britain's number 13. Phipps was to score 28 goals as Great Britain eased to victory. Final score, Great Britain 54, Belgium 49.
This morning's session at the Excel Centre consisted of bronze medal matches for the mixed individual. Boccia provides a true test of an athlete's technique, nerve and ability to perform under pressure. Players win points for getting their balls closest to the white ball known as the jack. Roger Andelin from Norway is one of the sport's most experienced players. He made his international debut back in 1991, and this is his fifth Paralympic Games. Here he is in the bronze medal match in the BC1 class against Brazil's José Carlos Chagas de Oliveira. He made a big move to start with a four in the first end. The Brazilian responded with a three, but towards the end, the 47-year-old Norwegian showed his experience and took the bronze medal 6 points to four. This adds to the silver medal he won in Athens in 2004. China have won silver already at these games in the BC1 class of the mixed team, and Kai Jong was hoping to add to that tally. But up against South Korea's So Young Jung in the BC2 class, it wasn't going to be easy. Jung scored in every end and accumulated five points, leaving Jung with just the one. So South Korea win their first Boccia medal of these games. Portugal also have silver in the bag at these games, and Jose Macedo had another South Korean Hansu Kim to overcome to take bronze in the individual BC3. This was a low-scoring match, but the opening two from Macedo turned out to be the pivotal score. And winning by 3 points to two, Portugal added a bronze to their medal tally. And in the BC4 class, a battle for bronze was between Brazil's Eliseu dos Santos and Stephen Maguire from Great Britain. Brazil have already claimed gold in the mixed pairs at these games, and Santos was determined to win an individual medal. He did the damage in the first two ends, and despite a late attack from Maguire, the bronze medal went to Brazil by 5 points to three.
In the men's football five-a-side today, Turkey played Great Britain in the match to decide who'd finish in seventh and eighth places. With Great Britain taking an early lead through Kerin Seal, scoring after just 5 minutes. All the players are visually impaired and wear blindfolds to ensure it's the same for everyone, and the ball has a bell in it. Turkey's best chance of the half was set up by number 10 Uzun for number 6 Kunduz. His shot, though, was straight at goalkeeper Lewis Skyers. The goalkeepers are not blindfolded, and some of them have normal eyesight. Ali Hidir Kirk saving well from Robin Williams. Great Britain did get a second goal, though, to their captain David Clark after 48 minutes, Clark signing off his international career. So Great Britain clinching seventh place in the tournament with a 2-0 victory. In the match to decide the five and six classification, Iran played China. The best chances to score in normal time fell to Behzad Zardali for Iran and Wang Zubin for China, bringing a good save from the goalkeeper. So nil-nil at full time, and the match went into penalties. China had already missed one penalty when Wang Yafeng scored. And China was still leading 1-0 when Iran had to score their third and final penalty to take it into sudden death. Their coach couldn't watch. Amir Purasavi had his shot saved by goalkeeper Niu. As China clinched the fifth place finish, winning the penalty shootout 1-0.
The quarterfinals of the men's team event have been completed in wheelchair fencing at the XL. The first match saw top seeds Hong Kong take on Great Britain. Hong Kong's three fencers boasted four Paralympic medals between them, three of them won by Chung with his first coming at Sydney 2000. Great Britain had just a single medal, a bronze one by David Heaton in Barcelona in 1992. The home team put up a fight, but it was a one-sided affair with Hong Kong cruising to the win 45 points to 19. France won this competition the last time it featured in the Games in Athens 2004 and were up against Russia. Ali Matresh was part of that team and was hoping to repeat the success of eight years ago. The Russian trio of Ivan Andreev, Artur Yusupov and Marek Yusupov had all competed in the individual events but not managed the podium finish. It was neck and neck all the way through with France just nicking the win long after the other three matches had finished, 45-41. The third quarterfinal match, Italy against Ukraine, who had both won just one medal each thus far. For Italy, Matteo Betti won a bronze in the epee, whilst Andrea Makri was making his London 2012 debut. For the Ukraine, Anton Datsko scooped silver in the foil and had Mikhailo Bajikov and Andrei Demchuk as teammates. And it was Italy who kept their medal hopes alive, pulling away towards the end of a very tight match to win by 8 points, 45-37. The final match of the last eight was a clash between Hungary and favourites China. The three Chinese fencers had already won a silver and three golds between them in London and most expected Tian, Hu and Yi to add another one here. The Hungarians, though, did have the most experienced man in the competition. Paul Zekeris has won six Paralympic medals and one Olympic medal over six games. But he couldn't do much to stop the Chinese, who stormed through to the semifinals 45-29. So Hong Kong now face France, with Italy and China making up the other semi-final.
The XL North Arena 1, it's the women's team, class 6 to 10 in the gold medal competition for table tennis, and the Turkish team are really the surprise package here. Chinese, certainly defending champions, and they've made a great start there. First match in favour of Leilina against Kubra Oskoy, and that is 1-0, and it will be the first to reach three matches, of course. And this one, it's Kavas. Neslihan Kavas makes the first game. Wow, that's a great fight back against Fan Lei. She takes it 11-7 and then levels things up to all. And we now have the crowd here really appreciating a big fight here from Turkey. But it's China with the match point. Fan Lei, and that is it. It's 11-4 in the fifth. 3-2 in games in favor of China. They take a 2-0 lead. Leilina comes up against Neslihan Kavas again, and that is it. That is actually the end of the match, and that is the gold medal in favor of China. They've defended their gold from Beijing, and they have beaten Turkey by three matches to zero. So the bronze medal match then is between France and Poland in the class 6 to 10 category. Up first is the extraordinary Natalia Partyka, and this left-handed attacking player. Absolutely wonderful finish, and that is the first point for Poland against France. 11-9 in the third game, she won 3-0. The next one up is Audrey Lemova against Alicia Egner. And it was Lemova that came through first. 11-2 in the third. It was 3-0 in favor of France. That leveled things at 1-1. Then Partyka played against Lemova and won that one. So it was 2-1 at that stage in favor of Poland. This service from Claire Marie from France actually wins the match 12-10 in the third. She's taken it 3-0. And although there was a little bit of a face there, she'll be happy to level the match at 2-2. So the fifth and final match is Janskova with Partyka against Marie and Lemova. And this is the final rally, and it goes Poland's way. They have won the bronze medal by 11-5. In the third, 11-7, 11-3, 11-5. Partyka, the gold medalist in the singles, celebrates yet another medal. It's a bronze, and you know, she'll be so pleased for her friends, her colleagues, and her nation's representatives there that she's also provided them with the medal. They celebrate a plenty. Poland have won it by 3-2 against France.
The final day of swimming in the Aquatic Centre in London's Olympic Park began with the men's 100 metres breaststroke SB9 category. With the world and Paralympic record holder Kevin Paul of South Africa swimming in lane 4 in heat 3. Paul, who was born without some muscles in his left arm, has been a grade A student and received numerous awards. At the turn, he already led by almost 2 seconds. Paul won gold in this event in Beijing and has also been the world silver medalist in 2010. And he won the heat in a new Paralympic record time of 1:06.21 to be the fastest qualifier for the final by over 3 seconds. Ellie Simmons has become the face of the Paralympic swimming with the British public, and there was lots of home support for her in heat 2 of the women's 100 metres freestyle S6 category today. Ellie in lane 4 as the fastest pre-qualifier in this heat has already won 2 gold medals and a bronze so far in London 2012 and is seeking to defend the gold medal that she won in Beijing at the age of 15. At the turn, she was in second place behind China's Song Ling Ling. But Simmons is renowned for her speed over the final leg and was almost 2 seconds quicker than Song on this last 50 meters. coming home in 1 minute 16.68 seconds to set a new Paralympic record time. But a third gold medal for Ellie Simmons isn't assured. Swimming in heat three of this women's 100 metres freestyle S6 category was the current world record holder, Victoria Arlen of the United States. 17-year-old Arlen, who once spent 2 years in a vegetative state, set that world record mark in June, just 12 months after resuming swimming following a four-year absence. At 50 metres, she led the heat and was over a second faster than Simmons had been at this stage. And she was quicker too over the last 50 metres, clocking a time of 1 minute 14.74 seconds to exactly equal her own world record and set a new Paralympic record, taking almost 2 seconds off the record that had been set by Simmons just moments earlier. It'll take a supreme effort for Ellie Simmons to challenge Arlen for gold in this event. Swimming in heat two of the men's 100 metres breaststroke SB12 category for athletes with visual impairment was the current world and Paralympic record holder Maxim Baraksa of the Ukraine, swimming in lane four. Baraksa set those records, winning gold in Beijing 4 years ago, where he collected five medals in all, four of them gold. If he repeats that feat in London 2012, he's been promised big financial rewards by the Ukraine government, and he already has three gold medals. That fourth gold medal was certainly on his mind, as the 28-year-old kept plenty in reserve in this heat, content to follow Mikhail Zimin of Russia over the two lengths of the pool and finish in second place in a modest 1 minute 10.1 seconds, 2.5 seconds outside his world record time. Baraksa only the third fastest qualifier for the final, but still the swimmer to watch. Carolina Pelandritu of Cyprus is the world and Paralympic record holder in the women's 100 metres breaststroke SB12 division and swam today in heat two. The 26-year-old from Limassol won gold in Athens and Beijing in this event, and the Cyprus government created a postage stamp in her honour, nicknamed Princess of the Pool. She wasn't in the lead at the halfway turn, trailing Natalie Pronina of Azerbaijan by 22 hundredths of a second, but came back strongly over the final length of the pool to win in 1 minute 19.33 seconds, well outside her world and Paralympic record time, but fastest qualifier for the final and favourite to win this gold medal for a third time. Another world and Paralympic record holder in action today was Daniel Dias of Brazil in the men's 100 metres freestyle S5 category, heat two. Dias going for his sixth gold medal here at London 2012, having won all his individual events so far. And he led comfortably at the halfway stage. Dias won nine medals in total in Beijing, four of them gold, and he's an ambassador to the Rio Games of 2016. He was never really stretched as he won in a time of 1 minute 14.16 seconds, 2.62 seconds ahead of Roy Perkins of the United States, and comfortably the fastest qualifier for tonight's final. Natalia Proglaeva of the Ukraine has won gold in all her three events so far, and in the women's 100 metres freestyle S5 today was looking to make it 4 out of 4. She was swimming in lane 5 in heat 2 and up against the current world and Paralympic record holder and the defending champion from Beijing, Teresa Perales of Spain in lane 4. Proglaeva, who led by just under 3 seconds at the turn, has set new world records in two of her three gold medal swims so far, but didn't threaten the world record in this event. Content to win in just 1 minute 20.62 seconds and save the big effort for tonight's final. Oleksiy Fadina of Ukraine was a big star at Beijing with five medals, three of them gold, but he's only won a bronze here. That could change, though, in the men's 100 metres breaststroke SB13 division, where he's favourite to take the gold medal. Fadina, who's 24, has certainly underperformed so far at London 2012, but this is his favourite event, and he won the gold medal in Beijing. His winning time, 1 minute 5.12 seconds, was easily the fastest of the qualifiers for tonight's final. Heat 2 of the men's 200 metres individual medley SM11 category featured Yang Bozun of China in lane 6, who's already won five medals so far, two gold, two silver and one bronze. Yang has previously auctioned his gold medals to give money to students with disabilities and sold another gold medal to aid the victims of the Sichuan earthquake in 2008. He was marginally back in second place at 50 metres behind Viktor Smirnov of the Ukraine, but soon moved up into the lead. Yang is also a musician who wrote the song The Voice of the Dragon for the 2008 Paralympic Games in Beijing, and he won comfortably in 2 minutes 23.43 seconds, a new Asian record, the fastest qualifier for the final by over 7 seconds. The Paralympic record in the women's 200 metres individual medley SM11 category had already been beaten in Heat 1 when Germany's Daniela Schulte lined up for the start of Heat 3. 30-year-old Schulte from Berlin developed a visual impairment at the age of 9 and began competitive swimming at 13. She's the world record holder in this event, and at the halfway stage she led New Zealand's Mary Fisher by just over 2 seconds. Schulte was the flag bearer at the opening ceremony and won her first individual gold medal in the 400 metres freestyle. And she dominated these heats, setting a new world, Paralympic and European record of 2 minutes 48.86 seconds, easily the fastest of the eight qualifiers for the final. Tonight's 15 finals will complete these extraordinary 10 days of swimming here at London 2012.
On the penultimate night of athletics competition in the Olympic Stadium in these Paralympic Games, there were medals to be won on both the track and the field. In the final of the men's 400 metres T11 class, the reigning champion at this event, Lucas Prado of Brazil, was in lane 4, with the silver medalist from Beijing, Jose Sioga Armando, in lane 8. It was Armando, though, who was to come out as the winner this time. They swapped places, in fact. Prado coming home to take the gold medal in a personal best time of 50.75 seconds. Armando, the silver medalist, in 51.44. And the bronze went to Gauthier Chazon-Makunda of France. In the final of the men's 100 metres T42 class, Heinrich Popoff of Germany in lane 4 was aiming to complete a set of Paralympic medals in this event. He'd won bronze in Athens, silver in Beijing, and he claimed gold here, coming through right at the line. Popoff the victor in 12.40 seconds, a new European record, just ahead of Scott Reardon of Australia, and the bronze medal that went to Wojtek Schiss from Germany. Reigning Paralympic champion Oscar Pistorius was back on the track in the first round of the men's 400 metres T44 class. Pistorius in lane 4 came away to win comfortably to seal his place in the final. The first three in each heat qualified automatically. Pistorius running a season's best time, in fact, for the event, 48.31 seconds. David Berger from Germany also qualified as of right, along with David Prince of the United States. Blake Leeper was the winner from heat number one. In the men's 5,000 metres T11 category, the gold medal went to Christian Valenzuela of Chile. In the final of the men's discus throw, F32, F33 and F34 classes, there were world records set in each of those three categories. The bronze medal went to Lawari Balaz from Algeria, 22 metres and 30 for him in round five. That was worth 1,081 points. The silver medal to Hani Al-Nakhli from Saudi Arabia in the F33 class. He broke the world record with 34 metres 65. That converted to 1,113 points. And also in round five, the gold medal was won by China's Wang Yanzhang. In the F34 class, his throw of 49 metres and 3 centimetres was worth 1,166 points. The final day of athletics competition in the Olympic Stadium started with heats of several track events and built up to the finals for several classifications as well. There were two heats in the first round of the men's 100 metres T37 classification, three automatic places available in the final. World record holder Fanny van der Merwe of South Africa drawn in the outside lane here, but pushed all the way to the line by Mostafa Fatala Mohamed of Egypt. Van der Merwe, the winner, in 11.52 seconds, that equaled his own world record and set a new Paralympic record. Mohamed, the second fastest qualifier for the final. In the first round of the women's 100 metres T36 category, the first heat was won by Nadia Schaus of Argentina in 15.04 seconds. This heat, number two, proved to be much faster. The first three athletes all going faster than Schaus. Elena Ivanova of Russia in lane six had already won two gold medals in the 200 metres and the 4x100 relay. She crossed the line first, 14.65 seconds, and it looks like Jean of South Korea and Martinez of Argentina will be her main rivals in the final. In the first round of the men's 100 metres T34 class, heat one was the quickest. Walid Katila in lane three from Tunisia is the world record holder. And he powered away to set a new Paralympic record in this heat. Katila crossing the line in 15.95 seconds. And Hamadi, who came second in that heat, was also the second fastest qualifier. In the final of the men's 200 metres T38 class, the world record and Paralympic record holder Evan O'Hanlon of Australia was in lane 5. But he was also up against the silver medalist for the 100 metres, Dian Buys from South Africa. O'Hanlon, though, powering away with Buys and Zhu Wenjun of China in hot pursuit. O'Hanlon setting a new world record in the process, 21.82 seconds. Buys taking the silver medal and Zhu the bronze.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Paralympic medalists.
In the first round of heats for the women's 100 metres T54 class, Yu Wenjun of China in lane 5 set a new Asian record in heat 2. She got off to a great start. She won the silver medal in Beijing in this event. And she looks like a hot favourite for the gold medal now. She set a new Asian record in 16.10 seconds. The other qualifiers from that meet, Tatiana McFadden and Kira Lin Free. Dong Hongxiao won heat one. In the final of the women's 400 metres T37 class, Neda Bahi of Tunisia in lane 4 had already won a bronze medal at these games in the 100 metres, and she added a gold medal in this event. A comfortable victory in the end, setting a new African record in the process as well. Bahi finishing in 105.86 seconds, but a real race for the silver medal, which went to Victoria Kravchenko of Ukraine. Bahi, the gold medalist, Kravchenko in second, and Evgenia Trushnikova of Russia third.
Paralympic medalists.
In the final of the men's 800 metres T13 class, the reigning champion at the Lila Mame of Morocco was drawn in lane 2. The athletes in this final allowed David Correa of Kenya to make the early pace. And in the home straights, it was Abdelatif Bakr of Algeria who finished the strongest. Korea and Mame also fighting for the medals. But Baka first in 153.01 seconds, a new Paralympic record. Korea taking the silver medal and Mame the bronze. In round one of the men's 4x400 metres relay for T53 and T54 classes, there were only four teams competing in each heat. No automatic places in the final. The four fastest qualifiers would all go through. China had the inside lane. With one lap to go, China had the lead. And Zhang Lixin held on to that for China. No opportunity to hold up in the home straight with the fastest qualifiers only going through. China, the winners of the heat in 3 minutes, 8.27 seconds. In fact, three teams qualified from that one, South Korea and Australia. Thailand won heat two. In the men's 800 metres T52 class, the gold medal went to Raymond Martin of the United States. In the men's triple jump F12 class final, the bronze medal went to Dong Huai of China. He was already in third place in round two, but this second round jump of 40 metres and 20 centimetres was a personal best. The silver medal was secured by Vladimir Zayets from Azerbaijan. He was in second place already as he took to the runway in round two. His best of the competition is 15 metres and 1 centimetre. Incredibly, that would prove to be just 1 centimetre behind the gold medalist, another Azerbaijan athlete, Oleg Panyutin. Panyutin's first round jump was his best. 15 metres and 2 centimetres, a season's best. First and second places for Azerbaijan, but Panyutin the gold medalist by the smallest margin possible. In the final of the men's javelin throw, F54, F55 and F56 class, Manolis Stefanoudakis from Greece went into first place with this throw in round three. 27 metres and 37, that was worth 973 points, although the points were irrelevant in the end because all the medalists came from class F54. Alexei Kuznetsov from Russia took silver. His best effort in round five, 27 metres, 87. The gold medal throw, though, in round six from Luis Alberto Zepeda, Felix from Mexico. 28 metres and 7 centimetres. He took the gold medal by a margin of just 20 centimetres. In the women's javelin throw final, the F37 and F38 classes, all the medalists came from class F37. Georgia Bykov from Australia took the bronze medal. Her best effort came in round one, 29 metres, 84. The silver went to Zha Qianqian from China. She set an Asian record in round five. 31 metres, 62. But Sherlyn Coelho from Brazil held the lead from the very first round when she launched this throw. 37 metres, 86, and that set a new world record for the F37 class. The women's shot put F57 and F58 class was keenly fought between three athletes from the F58 class. Yukaria Iyatsi from Nigeria took bronze. She set an African record with that throw in round three, 11 metres 11. Bulgaria's Stila Eneva took the silver medal, also with her third throw of the competition. 11 metres 38, that was a new European record. But the world record went in round three to Angeles Ortiz Hernandez from Mexico. 11 metres 43, Ortiz Hernandez improving her own world best by 20 centimetres.
Your Paralympic medalists.
In the final of the women's long jump F13 category, the gold medal went to Ilse Hayes from South Africa. And in the men's discus throw F37 and F38 class, the gold medal went to Javed Hamdani from Iran.
Beijing bronze medal winner and world number three, Michael Scheffers went up against his Netherlands counterpart and world ranking number four, Ron Vink, in the men's singles bronze medal match. Vink started the first set in fine form, managing to secure an early break. But this didn't affect Scheffers, who was able to break back with relative ease. Scheffers capitalised on this momentum and went a break ahead, meaning that he had to hold serve in order to secure the first set. He went on to win his service game and take the first set 6-4. This, however, didn't rule Vink out of the match as he came back fighting in the second. Although both players were breaking back and forth, Vink managed to secure a lead of 5-3, meaning he was one game away from tying up this match one set all. Scheffers responded superbly to the pressure and even managed to come back from two set points to break Vink and stay in the set, which went to a tiebreak. The tiebreaker was largely an even affair as the players matched each other point for point. In the end, Vink secured the second set. Vink secured a 4-love lead in the third and final set, but Scheffers mounted a comeback, taking the score to 5-4. It wasn't enough, though, as Vink held his serve to win the match and take his first medal at the Paralympic Games. Final score, 6-4, 6-7, 4-6.